One day, when I came home from school, my mother told me, after you eat, you must go with Zera Masi to purchase some important books we need. So we went to a street in the Pohra area of Udaipur. Zera Masi knocked on the door of a house. An elderly lady came out and told us to follow her. We came to a small room where two ladies were sitting. We joined them on the floor. They asked me my name, surname, and about my parents, my school, to keep me busy talking. Suddenly, one of them held me down. She forcefully kept me in her grip and said, "See the golden bird up above the cupboard." As I looked up, the other lady pulled down my pants and cut my sterile hood. In grave pain, I shouted, "Bachao, bachao," as loudly as I could, but no one came to my rescue. The woman who cut me applied some ghee over the wound, put a semi-wet cloth there, and put to my pants again. I was too shocked to say anything. Zera Masi hugged me and said, "Please stop weeping." She brought me home, where my mother lifted me in her arms and gave me chocolates. But I felt cheated by her, and in revenge, I stopped talking with her for quite some time. Years later, when I married and faced painful sex, I realized the consequences went far beyond that one day with Zera Masi. I tried to find out why Pohra girls are cut, but found no mention of it in the Quran Sharif. So I began to speak and write against Khatna. I have no daughters, but thank God I have saved my granddaughter from this cruel practice.